everyone! So today we're building a dynamic day-night cycle in RPG Maker and a fully functional in-game time system. This video tutorial is designed to work with any version of RPG Maker and it's very easy to follow. By the end of this video, you won't just have a working system, you'll really know how it all comes together. If you want, you can download a pre-made demo on itch.io and follow the instructions to implement it into your project. The demo file has everything ready for you, assets, the PDF guide, and key event commands, neatly placed in the top left corner of the demo map, that you can easily move to your Common Events tab if you want. I'm Anya, your guide in this tutorial today, and this little bird on my head is Laurie. Simply follow along with this video tutorial if you want to understand how it works, or if you're using a different version of RPG Maker. If you prefer to read the guide, I provided the PDF that you can download on my itch.io page. Simply follow the link in the description. Imagine your game world transitioning from morning to night in real time, making it feel alive. Time isn't just ticking, it's shaping every moment of your game world, activating nighttime events, lighting lanterns, making fireflies flicker, and much more. Exciting, isn't it? Now let's get started and make your game shine brighter than the sun at high noon. This setup we're going to do together allows real-time changes in lighting, environments, and even NPC behavior. Like real-world time, our game's time needs to constantly change. We'll do this by using variables and conditional branches to track seconds, minutes, hours, days, months, and even years. We'll also be using parallel events to keep time running smoothly without any interruptions. Once that's set up, we'll add a dynamic time display so we always know what time it is. And then we'll create a smooth screen tint based on the time of the day and night so it looks very realistic. Next part is optional but fun. I can show you how to create a mini game with a counter that triggers events based on time. So, in this example, you see we have fireflies and they appear only at nighttime, but you can do whatever you feel like, shop opening hours, house windows opening and closing at specific times, or lanterns that shine only at night. There's so much you can do with this system. If you're loving this system so far, but want even more customization, you can grab the premium version for free if you join Anya Lolo Club. Premium version includes some extra tutorials, assets, and features that you're going to love. Basically, it expands on everything we'll cover in this video. Go check it out, you won't regret it. Let's set up our in-game time to track seconds, minutes, and hours. Each time unit will follow a simple pattern that you see on the screen. We'll use variables to store this dynamic information. Let's start with seconds. We'll create our first variable by double-clicking on any square on the map to open the event editor. Let's name it, say, game time main, because it's our main event, and trigger it as a parallel event. Then choose control variables, single variable, and in empty space we type, you probably guessed it, seconds. Hit OK. So we have just created our game seconds and our first variable. Now we need to simulate a second ticking by. Don't close this window just yet. First, we need to add 1 to our seconds variable to make sure our game seconds count properly. This line means each time the event runs, the seconds variable will increase by 1. And since we don't have anything to stop the event from running, like if-else command or a wait command, it will keep counting like 1, 2, 3, and so on. This way, time in your game will pass just as seconds do in real world. Amazing, right? Now we're ready to do our game minutes. So, when we hit 60 seconds, we've got a minute, right? Let's create the event to do just that. Now let's use a conditional branch to check if the seconds variable is greater than or equal to 60. Conditional branch, variable seconds, greater than or equal to 60. So if you look at the first line, it shows that seconds keep increasing every frame. And then we have conditional branch saying that if seconds reach 60, then let's create another variable for minutes. Control variables, create variable, variable minutes, add 1. We're basically done here. We just need to reset our seconds variable back to zero. Because if we don't, the seconds will just keep adding after 60, making it 61, 62, 63, and we don't want that. We just want to start tracking a new minute. To do this, simply add this line, control variables, set 0 to seconds variable. That will reset our seconds variable back to 0, so we can start tracking a new minute. By now, you probably know how to do hours and days already. Simply repeat the above process for hours. Do a conditional branch, create a new variable, add one to hours, and reset our minutes. And for days, we just make a slight change. Once you reach 24 hours, you've got a new day, so we can now set up the variables accordingly. Adding months and years is optional, but if you're up for a challenge, you can also track months and years too. This is perfect for games that feature seasons changing or long-term events. Time sure does fly when you're game making, doesn't it? Our in-game clock is ticking, but we can't see its effect on our game world yet. That's why we need to show time on screen at all times. We can do that by creating our time display, so let's add one now. Quick tip! To check that everything is working as it should, we can place an object on the map, like a signpost, see I got one here, and set it to show a message when interacted with. We can call the variables by number, like so, and then playtest. If everything is great, you will see our game time in action. The numbers aren't changing in real time yet, so let me show you how to fix that and make your time display change in real time. Now, let's make time move! With the text picture plugin from the demo file, we can create a clean, minimalistic UI that displays current hour and minute, current day count, and any other information you'd like. Here's how to set up a plugin command that updates the display dynamically. Find text picture plugin in a plugin manager and turn it on. In your event, we'll add a plugin command to display the text you'd like to have in your time display. We'll use variable numbers specified before, such as variable 3 for hours or variable 4 for days. Add some colors to it as well, like I used yellow code 17, but it's up to you. We can either write V3 or V003, doesn't matter. Next, use show picture command without specifying the image. It will be our text. Set X and Y of your time display location. Keep in mind, if multiple images share the same number, they will override each other. So don't forget to assign a unique number to each image. By following these steps, you'll have a visually appealing time display. But wait! It's always daytime in our game now. Let's fix that. We're on our final steps to bring our game world to life. Let's make time flow by creating an immersive atmosphere for our game. We can do this with the screen tint command. They're quick to set up but look really stunning. Here's what we're going to do. Create a new parallel event and call it day-night tint or similar. This is where things get exciting. Since 12 a.m. is essentially zero, here's how we set it up. If hours equal to zero, we change our screen tint to dark blue. Copy the numbers directly from screen and pause the video if needed. Add comments so you won't forget what these are. Okay, deep night is done. Next time slot is 5 a.m., so we do this. If hours equal to 5, then change our screen tint to warmer colors. That's going to be our sunshine. The rest is pretty straightforward. This is how we do 8 a.m. And for 6 p.m., we're going to use military time. So 6 p.m. is simply 18. Same goes for 8 p.m., which is 20. And we're done! We've got a dynamic day-night cycle now. Here's a hint. If your game features indoor scenes, make sure to reset the screen tint when switching between indoors and outdoors. I cover how to do this in the premium version of the system. Have you noticed that our game always starts at 12 a.m. or midnight? It might be okay for the spooky midnight setting, but what if we want to start the game at noon instead? Let's work on that. Create a new event, you can name it preset time, for example. This time we trigger it as an auto run. Control variables, hours, 12. And then control variables, minutes, 0. We've got our noon preset now at game start. Now we apply daylight tint to prevent nighttime glitches. I put 120 frames. Finally, we'll deactivate our auto run with a self switch. Control self switch A on. Boom! Your game now starts at the time you decide. Since we're tracking multiple variables in real time, optimizing your game is essential. Remember this event we did previously. We did it this way for ease of understanding, but there's a downside in this method as we tell the software to constantly check if the seconds variable has reached 60. To optimize this, we'll change the check from 60 to 1 to prevent overloading the system. But we still want this to happen every 60 seconds, not every second. That's why we need wait command of 60 frames. This makes your game run smoothly without overloading the system. 60 frames in RPG Maker is equal to 1 real-time second. Fun fact, if you skip the wait command, your game time will fly at a lightning speed. I found it fun and used it in my minigame to demonstrate the mechanics. In RPG Maker, events that run as parallel processes constantly check their condition every frame, many times per second. Notice there is no wait command for the screen tints. We have one in game time main event, but none here. That means the screen tint will keep applying over and over, which is very resource consuming and could potentially slow down your game. Let's fix that. Great! Using switches, we can make time-specific encounters that add game depth, making the game world feel alive and reactive to time. In premium version, I have included an example on how to make fireflies appear only at night. You can use this as an inspiration to create all sorts of themes, such as shops opening and closed based on time, affecting the behavior of townspeople. Night-only events, opened and closed house windows, lanterns lighting up, or night creatures coming out. And a lot more. There's so much you can do with this system. You can download the premium version for free when you join Anya Lolo Club. All future updates are free for subscribers. Here's a sneak peek of what's coming next. Pause time. Learn how to freeze time during dialogues and cutscenes. Global time. Extend the time system to run across all maps. 12-hour display. Create AM/PM time displays. Got an idea or a question? Let me know in the comments. And just like that, your game world now feels alive with a dynamic day-night system. If you enjoyed this tutorial, check out my other demos and extended guides and my Itch.io account. See you in the next video. Bye!